my nuts swollen. All right. Well, some, as most of you guys might know, can you hear me? All right. All right, as most of you know, I'm Alyssa's sister, Erica. We and Alyssa are kind of unique. As Evan said earlier, we're triplets, along with our brother Jeff. But as distinctive as Alyssa and I are, you know, being born 1 minute apart, we do share something kind of in common. We have two of the most common last names in America. 4 years ago, I became Mrs. Smith. Now we have a Mrs. Jones. You made the top five. Alyssa and I are very different in several ways, too. As Evan mentioned, Alyssa is an excellent writer and editor. I actually became an auditor, so we're kind of different in that way. But using my analytical skills and Alyssa's writing skills, I'm actually going to address you, Nate, and let you know and give you some insight into the awesome woman you're marrying. Okay? All right. Now, since I've lived in Missouri and Alyssa's lived in Tennessee, we don't always get to talk as much, and I don't always know what's going on in her life, but as you guys know, she blogs. So if you guys read Alyssa in Nashville.com, she's helped me write this speech today. So here we go. So Nate, here's three awesome things about Alyssa. Number one, Alyssa is crazy about you. All right. In the subsection of Alyssa's blog, she has a section called Make My Day. And every day, she lists three things she's thankful for. Now, of the approximately 189 days that Alyssa and Nate have been engaged, Nate's name appeared just 125 times. So, Nate, this means that you made Alyssa's list about once every 1.5 days. So, I have no doubt that you'll make her list the remaining 176 days this year and the rest of her life. Number two, Alyssa's awesome and you can't live without her. Now, I want to make a disclaimer at this point that, Nate, I'm not taking an opportunity to make fun of you as much as I am trying to make a point that Alyssa's awesome and you can't live without her. So, according to Alyssa's blog, these are all from this year. In January of this year, Alyssa discovered Nate in her bathroom attempting to cut his own hair. After realizing that Nate looked like Forrest Gump, she resourcefully made Nate put on a trash bag, she watched a YouTube video, and became an expert hairstylist. Nate, what would you do without her? Alright, in February of this year, Alyssa started some major planning for the wedding, and she bought her dress. At this point, Nate concluded that all there was left to do was, and I quote, is get people to the church and feed them. Luckily, Alyssa was very respectful and took your advice and did some additional detail planning. But Nate, what would you do without her? All right, in March, Alyssa made the best chocolate chip cookies Nate has ever eaten. She made them with mini chocolate chips so she could get just the right ratio of chocolate to cookie. Alyssa said that Nate helped, but mostly he helped eat them. Nate, what would you do without her? All right, we made it to April. Alyssa and Nate were driving home from the store when Alyssa sees a spider crawl across the windshield. And here's a direct quote from Alyssa's blog. So he, Nate, tries to punch it. And my worst fear comes true. It drops. Now I'm really freaking out because I know he didn't kill it. And it was somewhere near my feet or possibly in my lap. We hit a red light, thank goodness, and I turned right into a parking lot and jumped out. Nate found that sucker on the floor mat and smashed it. And then I let him drive. Nate, I know Alyssa makes you feel like a hero. What would you do without her? In May, Alyssa and Nate went cicada hunting. According to Alyssa, she lets Nate do all of this actual cicada touching. Nate, Alyssa is adventurous and lets you have most of the fun. What would you do without her? And finally, in June, Alyssa began painting her bathroom misty aqua. From what Nate has already told me, it's his favorite color right after toothpaste green. Now, Alyssa has her house all ready for you to move in. What would you do without her? Now, number three, and I'll end with this one, Alyssa gets it. And what does Alyssa get? She gets it, what Jesus Christ did for us. I can't imagine anything better than marrying someone who even begins to understand the most instrumental and vital truth in life and has a passion to serve and love and worship Jesus Christ. Every time I visit Alyssa, I'm inspired to deepen my relationship with my Savior. And she's quoted numerous passages and sermons and books on her blog, but I think her love for Christian rap and hip-hop explains it best. So here's an excerpt from one of her favorite rap songs. And I'm not going to rap it. All right. It says, "This is us. Heap up your good deeds. Chant, pray, meditate. Well, all of that, of course, is spraying cologne on a corpse. Or you could choose to ignore it as if something don't stink, like stepping in dog poop and refusing to wipe your shoe. But all of that ends with, how good is good enough? Take your silly list of good deeds and line them up against perfection. Good luck. That's like past your pay grade. The cost of your soul, you ain't got a big enough piggy bank. But you could give it a shot, but I suggest you throw away the list. Because even your good acts are an extension of your selfishness." But here's where it gets interesting. I hope you're closely listening. Please don't get it twisted. It's what makes our faith unique. Here's what God says as part A of the gospel. You can't fix yourself. Quit trying. It's impossible. Sin brings death. Give God his breath back. You owe him. Eternally separated, and the only way to fix it is someone died in your place, and that someone got to be perfect or the payment ain't permanent. So if and when you find a perfect person, get him or her to willingly trade their perfection for your sin and death. Clearly, since the only one that can meet God's criteria is God, God sent himself as Jesus to pay the cost for us. Okay, Nate, congratulations on marrying my sister. She's a great catch. So let's recap. Number one, Alyssa's crazy about you. Number two, Alyssa's awesome and you can't live without her. And number three, Alyssa gets it, what Christ did for us. So here's a toast. To a marriage where Nate and Alyssa are encouraged and thankful for one another, and that they may continue to grow in their faith and in their bond with one another. Thanks, guys. Yeah.